Welcome to another tutorial on Introduction to Finite Element Methods. We are going to solve this problem right away. My name is Dr. Naftali Gadhemba, so let's dive in.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon.
You're given this bar and it's fixed on one end. On the other end, we can see a small gap here. So, and this is the test on this question. So how do you handle this gap here so that now we can be able to evaluate? Because the question requires us to determine what are the support reaction. Actually, this is a full statement of the problem that you are to require the, to determine the support reactions. And we know for this add support or node 3 to have a reaction, then it means it has to be to touch the support. So given the load applied at the midpoint P is equals to 6 times 10 to the power 4 newtons, the Young's modulus E and the area A, length L, and this gap is given. So the first step that we need to do is to obtain what is this gap. If it touches here, we know that you have reaction 1 and reaction 3. If it doesn't touch, then you know the reaction here will be a 0. It will be like just a bar supported on one edge, stretched, but the other edge is free. You know, from your string of materials or from mechanics, you found how to obtain for a bar element that is suspended or spooled on the one end. We know that if let's say we have that as your bar, I know that time you used to apply them like that, and then the load is applied on this end. And then we have the material geometry A, and of course the length is given, right? And then we have the property E. We derive and we know that the elongation is given by PL over EA. In our case here, if you look carefully, this is another small test that you need to be careful of. The load is applied at midpoint. What does that mean? From this part to this part, there is no stretch expected. We are only stretching this length of the bar, which is length L, not twice L. If the load was applied at node 3 and pulled on this direction, then we'll be talking of 2L. So you go right ahead, you know that the initial length is L, then you go straight ahead and you substitute. P is given 6 times 10 to the power 4. L is, the L itself is 150. So you're saying it's only this L, the first L that is being stretched, the bar is being stretched from this part. This material is only that you go erogation or stretch, then E times A. So you get, once you work that out, you're going to obtain, the erogation will be 1.2 millimeter, but the gap is 1.2 millimeters. So we know it should touch here and of course push. And we know with action acting on this support on this node, then we expect the reaction to be experienced. Good. Now that we have established that, we go straight ahead now to finite element procedures. First, we need to get the what is the stiffness or what is the stiffness matrix for this element. There are different approaches or different criteria for you to establish the node. Of course, here you've been given 1, 2, 3 explicit tree. But we said where there is a load application, because the load is applied at the nodes in finite elements, you can choose one that to be like a node. So here we know 0.2, the load application point, we can take as a node. So we can discretize or subdivide our structure into our bar structure in two bar elements. We have the bar element one, this one will be the element two. And so K1 is equals to K2 because the materials properties and geometries are the same. And this one in lesson number 3, we found that, and you can click the link here to watch that lesson. It's very important to revise that. And with that, you just now need to we say that this is EA over L, 1 minus 1 minus 1. One. This element of stiffness matrix for a bar element. And these are oriented in the same coordinate system. So the next stage is that we just need to, because we know K1 is equal to K2, we just need to do the assembly. We need to assemble. So of course, for K1, we have K1 is, we have a displacement here, U1, U2, U3. So for K1, we'll be having 1, 2, or U1, U2. For K2, we'll be having U2, U3. By the principle of superposition, due to compatibility, principle that is, two nodes remain connected, then we can go straight ahead and assemble that to get what is the global stiffness matrix. This is the assembled stiffness matrix, superposition of the two. Now with that, we move to, from the stiffness matrix, we go to what is the finite element equation. And the finite element equation, we just need to introduce the other components that we're missing, the force vector and the displacement vector. Remember, the finite element is F is equals to K times the deformation. So the component of nodal degrees of freedom, the applied nodal loads, and of course K. So the K is here we have obtained. This is displacement. This is force. So the reaction we are supposed to determine. The next stage at this, we have this reaction side, the load side, F1, F2, F3. And we have found that at node 3, our bar is stretching and touching that node. So we expect to have a reaction S3. In this case, now we need to get what are the boundary condition and what are the loads so that we can be able to obtain what is F1 and F3. Now, F2 is equals to P. And then F1 is the reaction. F3 is the reaction at node 3, 1 and 3 respectively. So this boundary condition, so we have F2 is equals to P. And P is given by 6.0 times 10 to the power 4 newtons. And then we have, what else is known? No dot degrees of freedom. No, U1, because of the support here, U1 is equals to 0. U2 is equals to delta, because we have seen that it's going to cover this. It's going to erogate. Assuming that this support was not there, it was to erogate 1.8 millimeters. But the gap here is 1.2, and then it meets that support. So our support is fixed. So we know the displacement at this node is delta. So now go straight ahead and solve this equation. We want to solve now for the unknown degrees of freedom. So the displacement before we go to reactions. If you look at this, these are just three simultaneous equations. So if you take, we want to calculate what is U2. Because if you want to get F1 and F3, if you look at this, we have two unknowns, because this one, we have F1 will be this times this, so this one will be 0, okay, minus U2 plus this 0. Oh, F1 is equals to minus EA of L U2, okay? So we need to get what is U2 first, okay? That's why we always maybe start with getting what is the degrees of freedom. And remember the 7 step from lesson one? The 7 steps of, or 8 step in the finite element analysis approaches. So we first get the unknown degrees of freedom. I think step 6, yes. Then 7, we can now start getting the reaction and recovery of other like stresses and so on and so forth, the derived quantities. So with that, so you take the second equation is one with U2. This one you're going to have, this times this is 0. This times this is, so of course, EA of L is out there. Then into bracket, 2U2, and of course now, minus delta gives P, okay? So you want to get U2. So you make U2 the subject of the formula. And by doing so, you're going to get U2 is a half PL EA of L. So it's 1.5 millimeter. So U1 is 0, of course, from the support. U2 is 1.5, U3 is 1.2. And we found from the first equation that F1 is equals to minus U2. So even going directly here, you're going to, okay, you've put the values, the calculated quantities here, and then the known values on the other side. So you're just going to get F1 is equals to EA over R. We found it's minus U2 EA over L from the first equation. So that is minus 5 times 10 to the power 4 newtons. Now, again, you can go to F3, which will be equals to 1 minus this times this is equals to F3. So by that, you get this minus 1 times 10 to the power 4 newtons. And that's the end of that very simple tutorial. Let me know, do you have any problem understanding that, because it was a very simple problem. Any other question you might be having concerning our tutorials and our ongoing lectures, then you can always leave the comment in the comment section, and we are going to solve together with you. That's all from my end. Thank you. Continue subscribing, sharing, and liking. God bless you.